Jack Wood for what?
Jack.
What will I use?
Audio source.
The audio source. We've got two speak on cables, what are these for?
For the speakers.
Connecting the speakers. And we've got the mixer over there. Is there anything, we're setting this up outside, is there anything we're currently missing?
Girls.
Stands, well remembered.
Got
so speaker stands.
Booze.
Don't need
a
kettle.
Booze, yeah.
So guys, what is the last thing that we're missing?
Microphone.
Tape. So we could use a microphone if we need to use a microphone, but we need gaffer tape if we're going to be setting this up outside. Not necessarily, but we may need it. Okay, let's start moving things outside. So we're going to move these speakers first. I'm going to take those outside.
Oof.
Right, just put it down. I said, don't anybody lift until I say so. So when you're lifting with two people, you can't just go, right, you've got to do this, and then start lifting.
Time.
You need to time it. 3, 2, 1, lift. So they both lift at the same time.
Three.
No, stop. Straighten your back, bend your knees. Bend your knees, that's it.
3, 2, 1,
chin and lift.
Okay, let's take it outside. Hannah, Cole.
Sit that way.
Okay guys, so we're going to start setting it up. What's the first thing we need out here?
Power,
electricity. So we need to safely get the electricity from outside. Now we've got the access to two doors. Which is going to be the best way to take this?
Probably not through the front door.
Through the fire exit.
Yeah.
Okay. Imagine that we were having a garden party, and there was going to be 50 people out here in this courtyard.
50 people.
Put the
speakers
up against the wall.
Well, obviously
put it where? Okay, so
the extension cable's here, and you've got wires running all the way along there.
So if you've got the speakers here, they're generally going to be facing that way, aren't they? That means all your people are going to have to be in that space there to get the full effect of the sound.
Well, here then, obviously.
Well, you can't put it here.
There's water there, so I'll be
better. So we've got water at the back, Hannah says. Other ideas? So against that wall might be a good idea. Might be.
Start from bar now. E.
Just pull it out.
No. If there's one loose in that thing. Start from bar and then O. T. Yeah, and then you pike it.
Lift it. You're fighting against the floor there.
Yeah, I know.
That's cool. So I'm going to suggest, so the speaker will probably end up about here. So if we put it on the... Let's put it on the third, shall we, so the speaker ends up here. So you put it in the third. So we've got two holes above. Put it down, tight. Okay, where are you locating that stand?
You need this bit to be pointed at the side.
It's a fair argument, it's a fair point.
Where's the wall master?
I'll lift this. Remember, you lift the tip straight back, Harry. Communicate.
No.
Okay then, what's next?
Speakers.
Okay, how many people do we use to set up?
Three on one, two on two, three on
one. Exactly that, so, right, you can communicate with each other, what are you doing?
Right, so Zaine, Harry can lift it, because Zaine biceps, Harry time.
Communicate, guys.
Now directly.
Hello, Harry.
Right, make sure it's
guys, one hole. Straight backs.
That was a lot straighter as well.
Because we're going to connect the cables up. The cable's going to go in the back of the speaker.
We need to move it forward.
No. Why?
There's no space
at the back.
And
so
people get in the cable.
Yes, so we need... How many people should do this?
Three.
Why? Okay, so Harry, me and you, we're gonna lift this to hover it, and you're just gonna move this forward. We'll put one hand underneath and one hand on the handle. 3, 2, 1. Put forward. More, that'll do. Happy? What do you think, Cole?
No, yeah, I'll start with the cable
system.
Okay, right. Do you want
to... Seems as though I did the heavy manual lift.
We did the heavy shit.
Are you even wrapped?
Yeah, because no one's going to be standing here.
So we're connecting up the phono. This is going to be for the what? For the laptop, which is also known as the audio. Now, what did you
move out the way?
What's Zaine just done? Has Zaine just done that right? Wrong one.
Oh, shit.
So remember, there's red and white, left and right.
Yeah, but look. Milky Way, black and white.
Well, look at them.
No, no. Oh, left.
So yeah, left and white, right and red.
The ST sub out.
Is that what it says? Yeah. Stereo sub out. So the first time, when you plugged it into left, so you plug that into left side.
The A, number A. That's
left. That's out. What's sausage?
We've not switched this on yet. What do we need to do before we switch this mixer on?
Volumes down.
All the volumes down. Look at them at the minute. They're all the way up.
Boop.
That's it.
Boop.
That's it. It's better be the best music I've ever heard.
It's not. Your ears are going to start bleeding.
Wait, I just need to bring this.
So guys, when we're dealing with the volume control, gather round. First thing we do is we're going to turn the stereo mix up. I'm not going to turn it all the way to zero, I'm just going to turn it about halfway. And then I can see a flash of a signal there. What do I need to do with that channel for the sound to come? What do I need to do with this channel for the sound?
Turn it on.
Turn it on, and then I can start to bring it up.
Play it.
Okay, so we need the sub. We need to sort the sub. Turn the sub on.
So the sub.
Turn it on.
Where? At the back.
At the back of the sub.
Oh, at the back. Oh, is the sub not even on?
Where's the boot on? Yeah, Harry, you just use your
arms. And how do we turn the level up of the sub?
Where's the ST sub on?
Do you
want to
reel this out?
Stop it.
I mean, ST.
Do you want to reel this out?
Right, we've latched.
Come on.
Big up Ashpeta on the scene!
Atom Zaine, yes, I do this rap thing, and I do it with these. Here's the mic, because I've got his car key. We're dismantling the PA system. What is it that you're...
First thing we're going to do is take the wires out. Normally we move the mixer and that, obviously, first. I mean the speakers first, but because the speaker's on a slant, it could whack the mixer and destroy it or damage it.
So we're going to get taking out the cables out.
We're taking the cables out.
We'll be right back. Hannah, Zaine, Cole and Harry. And we've just set up the PA system and we've just dismantled it just this moment. So just the last little bit, we just want to talk about what we did, the things that we need to think about when we were setting it up and when we were packing it down, some of the things that didn't go well, some of the things that could have gone better, and what we could have done to sort out those things, and some of the things that did go well. Okay. Talk to me. Yeah.
When we were putting it up, the things that went well was when we put the speakers on, but if it wasn't in a slanty place, it would be better. Because when dismantling it, it wouldn't have been a hazard, that speaker, like, damaging anything or falling over.
I think dismantling, we were much more efficient and we seemed to get it done like a lot faster. But the first time we had to sort of...
So yeah, guys, the time it took you to dismantle that equipment was probably around 10 minutes. It took you, and that's how long it should take. And depending on the size of the system and how many bits of kit you've got. To set it up, it probably took you about half an hour. It probably took a fair while. Now, you can be forgiven for that because you haven't done it in a while. You've done it a couple of times, but you haven't done it in a little while. But I would fully expect now, if we were to go and set it up, that you guys would get this set up in 10 minutes.
Yeah, but that's because we was all doing one thing. Like, if we all did that one thing, then we'd be doing it in 5 minutes.
We were doing that, like, in dismantling it, we were all doing different bits at the same time, whereas we're cutting it up, we were having, like, one person doing one thing while everyone waits, and then another person did another thing. I think that may be why it took so, like, much longer, because...
So you mentioned the ground not being level.
We could have changed the location.
We could have changed the location, because as it stands, when we actually did the sort of performance, were the speakers in the ideal position?
No.
They weren't. Where in the yard do you think would have been better?
Facing towards the gate, because we're all stood along that back wall, and the speakers were facing towards the side wall instead of where everyone was sort of congregating.
So as the listener, where do you want to be in relation to the speakers?
You want to be facing the speakers, you want to be like far from it, but facing. Yeah. So at least the sound's coming your way, not...
Yeah.
So you're not catching the reflection if you're actually getting the direct sound.
And of course the floor would have been flat
there
as well, so that probably would have been a better option. I noticed nobody used any gaffer tape. Why was that?
Because the system was up against a wall, so all the cables were along a wall, sort of, on the wall, so no one's going to trip us.
Yeah. So in the real world, I wouldn't have wasted my tape either. There would be no point, the cables were behind, no, it wasn't a through place.
And there was no big audience, only about 5-6 of us.
Yeah. But even if it was crowded out there, the only thing I'd have done with tape potentially was put it around the stands, but even
so
then...
So apart from in all there not to go past them.
Yeah, but even then, I wouldn't necessarily have even done that, because in the daytime, people aren't really likely to trip over the stands. Mm-hmm. The tape's not going to make a difference. At night, in the dark...
We need to go in the dark.
Then. Yeah, or glow in the dark tape or high vis tape, something that's going to be quite bright. Are you happy with how it was all set up in the end, more or less, apart from?
Yeah, just sort it out with the wires.
Just sort it out. So, what did you do with the wires, huh?
Guys.
Just
made sure they were safe. Made sure they were safe by
doing what? Wrapping them up.
Yeah. Instead of them all being tangled. Yeah. And of course, if you wrap up the cables in that way, rather than them all being tangled at the back, it's easier afterwards, so you're making yourself light work for later as well, and that probably helps with the efficiency of packing up. We use this extension cable. Now, is there anything that you need to think about when using things like PA systems and extension cables outside?
Make sure it's out of the reach of the audience.
So out of the reach of the audience, anything else you want to say?
Away from rain and weather and bad weather.
Rain, water, bad weather,
all the water. If water went in that extension and it was plugged into your thing, this whole place would be great.
Yeah, what were you saying, Harry?
Make sure the location is like close in relation to like main power. Like, so, because you don't want to be trailing like massive, like mile and mile of extension cable. It's easier to like have a short cable on that trip.
But sometimes you've got no choice. sometimes you do have to run a long cable, but of course you need to make sure that you're safe when you're doing that. This particular one here, this particular extension cable, is not like every other extension cable. It's got what's called a thermal cutout. Can you all see this?
That stops the power.
It stops what? It'll cut the power under certain circumstances. What are the circumstances? Yeah? But think about the name of it. If it's too hot. If it's too hot, but what would cause it to get too hot?
Overheating, either being outside in the sun or just having loads of stuff on it.
What do you mean by loads of stuff on it?
Like I've forgotten what it's called. I know what it is, where there's like too many things on
it. When we first went to set up, I had to stop you guys from lifting one of the speakers. Why was that? What were you doing that wasn't quite right? So there was that?
No, but we picked it up straight away, like we just quickly picked it up.
And why was that wrong?
Because we were supposed to take our time, go down slowly, and then pick it up slowly.
But there's another thing.
You need to give your partner.
Yeah, you need to make sure you do it at the same time.
Do it at the same time. What's the word? The C word. Not the little C word.
Teamwork.
Call.
Compression. Conversation. Bye.
Communication.
Communication.
I